Warning, this video contains spoilers. Chilling Adventures of Sabrina is a fantasy teen series that aired between October 2018 to December 2020. It had 4 seasons and 36 episodes until it was ultimately cancelled. Despite the Chilling Adventures of Sabrina's short lifespan, it still had reasonably large following and it had a great potential to be bigger than it ultimately became. I am aware of this series' inaccuracies of representing Satanism, Wicca, and witchcraft. The whole series seemed to have too fast momentum for its own good, since these types of writing mistakes could have been avoided with simply outside help and slowing down the production pace. It also didn't help that this show was clearly marketed as horror, like the name suggests. But the reality was that the horror elements usually buried down under the relationship drama, which is also great, but outside marketing should have been reflecting that so that the series could have found its right audience faster. I tried to look past these obviously unfortunate aspects and concentrate more on the things that made this show great, since there was a new release of the 9th issue of this comic book in 2021. Netflix also announced Sabrina's Riverdale crossover this Christmas on Netflix, in season 6, episode 4. So clearly the creator Roberto Aguirre-Sacasa desires to keep Sabrina's chilling story alive and sees its potential. So what makes Chilling Adventures of Sabrina so special? Cinematography and lighting has its own tone and look that draws the viewer into this eerie atmosphere. Whenever something weird is going on, the camera points it out by blurring out or lighting parts of the frame to switch the viewer's gaze on what's important on the screen. Cinematography in this case deepens the storytelling without dialogue. Same goes for the production, costume, and makeup design. Visually, everything looks beautiful and believable. It's impressive how they managed to create this unique atmosphere. Character-wise, the usual comic book style hero and villain complex is inevitable. Sabrina has everything going for her. At the same time, she's perfect, brave, self-confident, kind, wise person who consciously makes mistakes but never gets to face the consequences or change in the whole course of this series. It's great in comic books, but it starts to get dull after a while if the main character doesn't have any flaws or a clear character arc. Especially in a story concept like this, where teenagers grow and find their purpose in life. Don't get me wrong, I felt like actress Kiernan Shipka did everything right here. She cannot help if writing is against her, but overall I felt more compelled for the other characters of the story that had more depth and nuances to them. For example, Miranda Otto did an amazing job as the character Zelda. She is responsible, loyal, resourceful, and precise, but on the other hand, it makes her controlling, distant, and cold. As her character arc, we see her stepping into her own power by creating a coven, opening up and relying on others. Same goes for Michelle Gomez, who played the character Mary Wardwell. She's pure evil, cunning, power-hungry, and calculated, but on the other hand, she's also desperate and evokes sympathy in the viewer. Even one-dimensional characters get to have a moment in later seasons. For example, Lucy Davies, that plays the character Hilda, can be seen as kind people-pleaser that does what everyone tells her to do, but there are moments where she stands up for what she feels are important. Teenagers have way smaller character arcs than the adults for some reason, but Lawton and Watson as Theo and Tati Gabrielle as Prudence had potential that we got to see just the tip of the iceberg for them. All in all, I felt like this series gave the audience nuances of the idea of evil, anti-heroes, and challenge our thinking of how things should or shouldn't be. Healthy criticism and questioning of leadership figures and the conservative ways of living is inspiring. Hopefully this series lives on, if not in TV, hopefully in comic books. Thank you for watching. See you next time.